Hi, this is GoCode. Today we will see how to solve this problem named max product subarray. So the problem statement is simple. You are given an array having both positive and negative numbers, and we need to find the contiguous subarray within the given array containing at least one number which has the largest product. So let's see how we can solve this by taking an example. Let the given array is this: 5, 1, minus 6, minus 5, 3, minus 7. Here, if there were no zeros and negative numbers, then the answer would definitely be the product of the whole array. And let's assume there were no negative numbers and just positive numbers and zero in the given array. Then, in that case, we could maintain our current maximum product, which would be reset to AI when zeros were encountered. But when the negative numbers are introduced, the situation changes slightly. We need to now maintain the maximum product in positive and maximum product in negative, because on encountering a negative number, the maximum product in negative can quickly come into picture. By the way, this problem can be solved using various approaches, and I will be share one of the approach to solve this. So let's define two arrays. One is current max till index and current min till index. Here, current max till index I denotes the max product of the subarray of the array from 0 to I index including array I, and current min till index I denotes the min product of the subarray of the array from 0 to I index including array I. This is the main part, including array I. So how we will calculate these two arrays? We will use these equations to populate array current max till index and current min till index. So here, current max till index 0 will be the array 0, which is 5, and current min till index 0 will also be array I, which is 5. Now we need to calculate current max till index 1, which will be max of array 1, comma, current max till index I minus 1, which is 5, into array I, which is 1. 5 into 1, 5, and current min till index I minus 1, which is 5, into array I, which is 1, means 5. So basically, current max till index 1 will be max of 1, comma, 5, comma, 5. And so max here is 5. Again, we will calculate current min till index 1 using this equation, which says current min till index I equals to min of array I comma current max till index I minus 1 cross array I, in or current min till index I minus 1 cross array I. So the current min till index 1 will be also 5. Let's calculate these arrays. Sorry, current min till index 1 will be 1. This will be minus 6. This will be minus 30. This will be 150. This will be minus 5. This will be 450. This will be minus 15. This will be 105. And this will be minus 3150. Now our answer will be the overall max of this array current max till index, which is 450. So for this array, our answer will be 450. This solution takes O(n) time complexity and takes O(n) space complexity. We can reduce the space complexity to O(n) by taking variables global max product, current min product, and current max product, and update our global max product variable whenever we calculate current max product and current min product. If still you have any doubt, hope you will understand fully by seeing the implementation part. Now let's go to the implementation part. Hope you liked this video. Thanks for watching.